a little change in the range updates from now on, since now I am updated to firmware 10.2 instead of the old 8.1, because along with 10.2, starting December 26, 2020, Tesla started de-restricting older vehicles, and mine has been restricted to 94 kilowatt charge rate since about the second month of ownership. As such, I am now able to hit 112, and the weather's still a little cold out, so I might even get better than that. Anyways, it is 44 degrees Fahrenheit outside right now, and I charged up to, surprisingly, 251. Starting to warm up a bit, so yeah, it's quite possible that my charge rates are starting to improve. Yes, we have little Miss Mina. Say hi. Say hi. This is Cayman Girl. Come on. Say hi. Blow kissy. Vincent, leave her alone. Mina, can you blow kissy pose? Kissy pose. Yeah. Blow kissy pose.
Yeah.
Yeah? You don't want to? You don't want to do kissy pose? Okay, forget it. Back to updating. Where was I? Okay, yes. TM Spy, and that's too bright of a background to be able to see that. So we have car thing's pack capacity is 72.8 kilowatt hours. Unfortunately, remaining capacity is no longer going to be accurate because starting on firmware 10, Tesla now fudges the numbers. Like, though that number will jump up and down, up and down. Look at thinks I'm pulling 1,000 amps from the battery pack. There's a lot of stuff that's going to be off from now on. So unfortunately, that is not accurate. So we're going to have to unfortunately go with remote Tesla remote. The right vehicle. And of course that's not working. But why is this? Yes, I am not charging, and that's like 100 and something miles away from here. So yeah, okay, that's not working right now. But I think 72.2 was correct. Once when remote Tesla was working, I may have to log back in again. Also, SOC is no longer going to be, so that state of charge is no longer going to be accurate either. But we're looking at 11 millivolt of a, sorry, I can't hold this still. I'm still getting used to reading, Vincent, leave her alone. I'm still getting used to reading this as a, on firmware 10.2 in terms of the numbers being all wrong and off for certain things. Cell voltages, we have a slightly out of balance pack at 11 millivolts. Now this car was at a body shop for 2 months because I got T-boned on the freeway pretty bad. I'm surprised they actually fixed it. I was actually hoping they'd total it out and let me buy it back. Still trying to get the guy that that hit me. Illinois Tollway refuses to give me the license plate number. Completely different subject. Back to what's on hand. Discharge and total charge, that is accurate. So we got 46.768 megawatts discharge. Lifetime charge of 50.752 megawatts. Switch over to temperature. Meet Vincent, leave her alone. Wow, you're a bad big brother. Right now, it's a high of 89.8 and a low of 87. We've been here quite a while. That pack balance was pretty bad, and the car was really, really trying to balance it off. We've been here now 2 hours as it was trying to polish that off. Go on down over here. I forgot what we're always looking at on this one now. Usable. Nominal.
DC charge total, cycles, that's what it was. Discharge cycles, 642 charge cycles. Oh god, it's been a while since I've done a range update. What the heck is charge cycle? Oh, there we go. 697 charge cycles. That's why this feels weird. I never put my center console back in. Like I said, I picked this up 2 days ago from the body shop. So, finally getting to drive it. Alright, so that's it.